student. Welcome to e-classroom from Maulana Azad National Urdu University. Let us discuss about the topic skills of reading and writing from the general English for the students of BA, BCom, BSc first year. Let us discuss about reading. Reading has many uses. Through reading, we can acquire information, knowledge, pleasure, a large vocabulary and a good command of the language. Reading also has many problems. We are surrounded today by millions of words in the form of books, magazines, manuals, etc. In many languages, it will be impossible to read everything we come across. We must decide what to read and how to read it. Reading in English in a particular subject requires the following skills: knowledge of the alphabets, both capital and small letters; knowledge of spelling, how letters are combined to form words; knowledge of grammar, how words are combined to form sentences; knowledge of text organization, how sentences are combined to form paragraphs and how different texts are organized; sufficient vocabulary, knowledge of English punctuation, knowledge of different reading techniques. If you become an effective reader in English, you will have many benefits because there is no limit to the knowledge or pleasure you will get through reading in English. The first step in the effective reading is to decide what to read and how to read. Even in our mother tongue, we do not read everything. The choice of reading material is decided by various factors like personal interest, requirements of jobs, compulsions, etc. Students, for example, have to read everything that is prescribed for the syllabus. Doctors have to keep their knowledge up to date by reading medical journals. Office employees have to go through files. Another factor which decides reading is the availability and cost of the material. The selection and the choice of the material is important in reading. Let us move to the purpose. We read for some reason. We may read a newspaper to find out what is happening around us. We may read a magazine to enjoy its contents. Students read a text for the purpose of answering questions in the examination. We may read an encyclopedia for information. We may read a novel for pleasure. So, it is important to keep in mind why we are reading a particular material. Let us move to the strategies. It is necessary to learn different techniques of reading different materials. For example, we do not read a telephone directory in the same way as we read a newspaper. We scan a telephone directory for a particular number and we skim through a newspaper. These two techniques will be explained later. We study documents carefully, trying to understand the meaning of every word. We must study textbook many times to remember the information. In other words, we use different strategies to understand different materials depending on their nature and purpose for which we read them. We have to maintain speed. An effective reader is one who reads quickly but understands everything. Only a poor reader will read slowly and will stop at every word. When we read anything, our eyes move fast, taking in about three or more words at a stretch. The eyes may move backward and forward to double check. They do not stop to check the spelling or find out individual letters. With practice, our reading becomes fluent and silent. Loud reading should not be done except to practice pronunciation. Let us recapitulate. Reading is a very useful skill. It helps us to get information, knowledge, and entertainment. As you know, a person who cannot read will face many problems. To be able to read and understand English will bring many benefits. To become a good reader in English, you will have to improve your English language skills. Reading will help you to get those skills. There are different ways of reading different materials. Must we read differently? It is also necessary to read fast because there is so much to read nowadays and time is precious. There are different kinds of reading. We scan for information. We also read to get a general ideas in skimming. Then we read for a structure or organization of points. We also read to get detailed information from a text. In this unit, we will learn different kinds of reading. In scanning, we try to find specific information without wasting time reading every word. Our eyes move over the text quickly till we find what we are looking for, whether it is a name, date, number, etc. Scanning is useful when looking at a railway timetable, a telephone directory, advertisement, or finding a word in a dictionary. There are two main ways of scanning a text. Scanning means looking at a written text and moving our eyes quickly over it to get the information we want. In scanning, we do not want to stop to read every word or every line. Scanning saves time and is a very useful practical skill. Let us move to the skimming. Skimming means looking quickly through the text to get a general idea. We allow our eyes to move about the page without stopping till we see the piece of information we are looking for. In skimming, we take the help of the layout of the page, headlines, paragraphs, headings, use of capital letters, etc. This technique is useful in reading newspaper and similar material. When we get the newspaper in the morning, we do not immediately start reading from page 1 to line 1. We skim through the pages to locate interesting or important information. Let us recapitulate. Skimming means looking quickly through a text quickly to get a general idea. It has a practical value because it helps us in reading newspapers and other materials quickly. In skimming, we do not read every word. Let us know about reading for organization. Every text has a structure or organization. That is the way the points are arranged. The purpose of this structure to help the reader to understand its meaning and move smoothly from one point to another. Most texts begin with an introduction and finish with conclusion. Without an organization, it will be very difficult to understand a text. All texts, whether small or big, are divided into number of paragraphs. Each paragraph deals with a particular point or aspect of the topic. Reading for details. Apart from reading for structure, we also read to get detailed information from a text. In this unit, we will learn details of how discoveries and inventions have been made. Sometimes, by chance or accident, inventions not the same things as discovery. Discovery find things that we did not know before. Inventors create entirely new objects. Let us move to the aspect of writing. Writing plays a key role in the educational system and knowledge preservation. Students at all levels have to write examination answers, and at school level they have to do their homework. Job seekers have to appear for competitive and selection tests in which they may be asked to write an essay, a letter or a report. Secondly, knowledge which has been accumulated for thousands of years has been preserved only through writing. Without writing, this knowledge would have disappeared. We have, in addition, other forms of writing. Professional like doctors, engineers, lawyers, scientists, business persons, etc. have to do some writing connected with their work. Lastly, there is creative writing in the form of poetry, novel, drama, etc., which people enjoy reading. However, writing can be done only by educated persons, whereas even uneducated people can speak. Writing is considered both an art and craft because it involves imagination and control of language. Let us move to the writing process. Good writing needs careful planning. If you write down whatever comes to your mind, the result will be unsatisfactory. In order to make your writing effective and interesting, you have to keep in mind the following aspects. The reason for writing is called as purpose. Collection ideas or points known as contents. Arranging the ideas in a proper or logical order and linking them is called as organization. Following the conventions of writing, layout, spelling, punctuation, grammar called as correctness. Using range of vocabulary and being aware of reader is style. First, you must know why you are writing. Second, you should be able to gather relevant ideas or points by referring to books, newspapers, encyclopedias, etc. Reading also help in acquiring knowledge. Good thinking leads to good writing, and so you should develop thinking skills. You should be able to organize your material properly. Next, you should avoid mistakes in spelling, grammar, punctuation. Bad or incorrect writing will not please anyone or fetch marks in the examination. Lastly, you should be able to use a wide range of English words and also have a sense of who is going to read your writing. The success of writing depends on the awareness of audience. Writing for a newspaper is not same as the writing for a scholarly book. Mechanics of writing. Spelling mistakes often affect the quality of writing. English spelling is very irregular. As in Indian languages, spelling and pronunciation do not match. So, when you see a new word, you are not sure how you should say it. Similarly, when you hear an English word, you cannot show off the spelling. For example, the sound is written in different ways, K, CK, CH or Q. There are no reliable rules about spelling in English. So, the best way to learn the spelling of each word separately, remember that spelling makes mistakes give a wrong impression that your knowledge of English is not so good. Follow the procedure and you can be sure of your spelling. Always check with the dictionary for the correct spelling. If the spelling appears to be difficult, write it down 5 times in your notebook. Close your notebook and mentally practice the spelling. Keep a list of words which are spelled wrongly by you. Remember that some spelling are different in American English. Spelling is primarily habit. You have to learn to spell words correctly and make correct spelling an automatic habit. Since memory plays an important part in spelling, you should develop visual memory. Try to get a mental picture of the word by choosing your eyes and write down the word from the memory. Check the spelling and if it is wrong, repeat the process till you get the spelling right. To improve your spelling, look, cover, remember, write. Writing paragraphs. All writing is divided into paragraphs. A paragraph is defined as a unit of writing containing a sequence of sentences. These sentences express a main idea and are arranged in a specific way. In modern writing, even a single sentence is used as a paragraph. A paragraph is separated from others by a space in between and hence is easily recognized. Mastering the art of writing, a paragraph is essential to succeed in any form of writing, whether it is an essay, a letter, a newspaper, an article, a novel, etc. The characteristics of a good paragraph are topic sentence. A paragraph contains a central or controlling idea which is expressed in a topic sentence. Thus, the central idea is contained in the topic sentence. It may come at middle of the end or end of the paragraph. The remaining sentences in the paragraph provide supporting details. Let us know about the coherence. The sentences in a paragraph are interlinked by the same topic and also by the use of words and phrases known as linkers. These words and phrases are known as transitional devices and help us to follow the writer's line of thought by showing us how one sentence relates to another. Here is a paragraph about water. Let us study paragraph. Next to air, water is the element most necessary for survival. A normal adult is 60 to 70% water. We can go without food for almost 2 months, but without water for only a few days. Yet most people have no idea how much water they should drink. In this paragraph, the topic sentence is put at the beginning. The remaining sentence gives more details. Coherence is maintained by repeating the word water. Recapitulate what we have studied. Reading has many uses. Through reading, we can acquire information, knowledge, pleasure, a large vocabulary and a good command of the language. Reading also has many problems. We are surrounded today by millions of words in the form of books, magazines, manuals, etc. In many languages, it will be impossible to read everything we come across. We must decide what to read and how to read it. If you become an effective reader in English, you will have many benefits because there is no limit to the knowledge or pleasure you will get through reading in English. The first step in the effective reading is to decide what to read and how to read. Even in mother tongue, we do not read everything. The choice of reading material is decided by various factors like personal interest, requirements of job, compulsions, etc. We read for some reason. We may read a newspaper to find out what is happening around us. We may read a magazine to enjoy its contents. We may read an encyclopedia for information. We may read a novel for pleasure. So, it is important to keep in mind why we are reading a particular material. It is necessary to learn different techniques of reading different materials. We study documents carefully, trying to understand the meaning of every word. We study textbook many times to remember the information. In other words, we use different strategies to understand different materials depending upon their nature and purpose for which we read them. An effective reader is one who reads quickly but understands everything. Only a poor reader will read slowly and will stop at every word. With practice, our reading becomes fluent and silent. Loud reading should not be done except to practice pronunciation. Reading is a very useful skill. It helps us to get information, knowledge and entertainment. As you know, a person who cannot read will face many problems. To be able to read and understand English will bring many benefits. To become a good reader in English, you will have to improve your English language skills. Reading will help you to get those skills. There are different kinds of reading. We scan for information. We also read to get a general idea in skimming. Then we read for structure, organization of points. We also read to get detailed information from a text. Scanning means looking at a written text and moving our eyes quickly over it to get the information we want. In scanning, we do not want to stop to read every word or every line. Scanning saves time and it is very practical skill. Skimming means looking quickly through the text to get a general idea. We allow our eyes to move about the page without stopping till we see the piece of information we are looking for. This technique is useful in reading newspaper and similar material. Every text has a structure or organization, that is the way the points are arranged. The purpose of this structure is to help the reader to understand its meaning and move smoothly from one point to another. Skimming means looking quickly through the text to get a general idea. We allow our eyes to move about the page without stopping till we see the piece of information we are looking for. This technique is useful in reading newspapers and similar material. Every text has a structure or organization, that is the way the points are arranged. The purpose of this structure is to help the reader to understand meaning and move smoothly from one point to another. Apart from reading for structure, we also read to get detailed information from a text. Writing plays a key role in the educational system and knowledge preservation. Knowledge which has been accumulated for thousands of years has been preserved only through writing. Without writing, this knowledge would have disappeared. However, writing can be done only by educated person, whereas even uneducated people can speak. Writing is considered both an art and craft because it involves imagination and control of language. Good writing needs careful planning. If you write down whatever comes to your mind, the result will be unsatisfactory. In order to make your writing effective and interesting, you have to keep them in mind the following points: purpose, content, organization, correctness, style. First, you must know why you are writing. Second, you should be able to gather relevant ideas or points by referring to the books, newspapers, encyclopedias. Reading also helps in acquiring knowledge. Good thinking leads to good writing, and so you should develop thinking skills. You should be able to organize your material properly. Next, you should avoid mistakes in spelling, grammar, punctuation, etc. Lastly, you should be able to use a wide range of English words and also a sense of who is going to read your writing. The success of writing depends on the awareness of the audience. Spelling mistakes often affect the quality of writing. English spelling is very irregular. So, when you see a new word, you are not sure how you should say it. Similarly, when you hear an English word, you cannot be sure of spelling. So, the best way to learn the spelling of each word separately, remember that spelling mistakes give a wrong impression that your knowledge of English is not so good. All writing is divided into paragraph. A paragraph is defined as a unit of writing containing a sequence of sentences. These sentences express a main idea or arranged in a specific way. In modern writing, even a single sentence used as a paragraph. A paragraph is separated from others by space in between, and hence it is easily recognized. Mastering of the art of writing paragraph is essential to success in any form of the writing, whether it is an essay, a letter, a newspaper, etc. The characteristic of a good paragraph are: a paragraph should contain central or controlling idea which is expressed in a topic sentence. The sentence in a paragraph should be interlinked by the same topic and also by the use of words and phrases known as linkers. These words and phrases help us to follow the writer's line of thought by showing us how one sentence relates to another. In today's lecture, you have learnt about the skills of reading and writing. For the doubts and queries, please keep writing to the Directorate of Distance Education, Maulana Azad National Urdu University, Gachibowli, Hyderabad 500032. Goodbye and take care.